Southern Association of Accreditation for our campus, they said, you need to keep a list of all of the complaints that your school has ever had. And I didn't have very many complaints about it, but I thought, as long as I'm keeping the complaints, I might as well keep a copy of all the, of all the good comments too, right? And, you know, balance it out. If you want comments, I'll give you comments, okay? So I started keeping copies of everything that, that students started sending in about this. And this is just random stuff that I picked up from my different students here. Thank you for caring for your students. Oh my gosh, you're so awesome. Thank you. Your help today has meant the world to me. Thank you so much. You rock, okay? This is the time the students told you, you rock, okay? Because you helped them register. Okay. Now down here, I want you to notice here that we have instructors. I now have instructors who are calling me going, gosh, give me another weekend college. I love the weekend college. Now again, I've been an instructor for a long time. What does it feel like to be an instructor when all your students come into class prepared, ready to go, have their homework done, and are eager to learn? You're going, give me 15 more of those classes. Okay? And there's sometimes you have a class where you go, why did I ever get into teaching? I could be a garbage man right now, you know? But all of our students here are fantastic students. They're aggressive. They come in. They're ready. They challenge the instructor. They have their homework done. And not only that, but if you are an instructor who, part-time instructor, remember, you can get a full load by coming one day a week. Oh yeah, that's like an hour and 50 minutes one day a week, or maybe 4 hours if you do both classes. And then again, I keep telling more people about your program. Thanks for all you do. Happy Friday, okay? You know, yeah. I enjoyed the course setup, and then let's see, let me move this over here so you can just see a couple of more here. Here's another instructor. I enjoyed the course setup. Hope to be of use in the future. Keep me on the list. Okay, see you this summer. So we see a whole bunch of students and a whole bunch of faculty. I didn't do all of them because Dr. Morales said I had to keep it down, keep my comments down to a limit here. But I have tons of them that people are just excited about getting in. Finally, they have a focus. They know what they're doing. They're not blindly fishing, throwing out the bait and hoping for something. They know when they walk in what their classes are going to be, when they're going to be done, and how they're going along doing it. They know they get the intervention, they get the hand-holding all the way through, and they are just ready, ready to go through with it. So I think I just have one.
And David, before you hit play on the next one, again, you know, we have very dedicated faculty throughout the district, throughout the campus here. And in weekend college, as David stated before, you know, there is a special set of skills that faculty has to work with students in an accelerated mode. You know, if they are adults, that they have life issues and other things, it is something that is always a plus. And you know, through the comments that he showed you, is what we are seeing as an accomplishment from those professionals as well.
Okay, so we were doing a video and we were putting together from student comments that we had in regards to all three of our disciplines. Remember, we're non-traditional, so we have dual credit, online learning, and then the weekend college. So I got the part just for the weekend college. And I don't know if this will play. If it doesn't play, I've got it on. It does.
I had some other choices, but it was not going to be as efficient. I'm going to take one class at a time, and it was going to take a little bit too long, I think. So I kind of want to focus, get it done, and move on. So I stopped to work during the day.
Some of the benefits of being enrolled in weekend college is that you get to meet others that are pretty much going through the same thing that you do, that you're going through, such as having to work and just gaining knowledge from them on different things, such as how they work their time management along with weekend college. So it's a lot of sharing, and it's like a little nice knit family.
I have realized that I can do this. I have believed for a long time that maybe college isn't for me, and I'm doing very well. I'm getting a good, well, really holding a high GPA, and I think that is the biggest benefit for me, is that I'm proving that I can do it, and I can be a good student.
The benefits of weekend college is being able to have that flexibility. You're still able to work. You're still able to be that mom, dad, or whomever. You know, you're still able to have family and still be in college.
I say just do it. Do it.
So those are two of my children who grew up with me from day one, okay? They were there from the very beginning. And let me tell you about Gina. She was the one who said I wasn't sure I could do it and all this kind of stuff. She's been a homemaker for, I don't know, 50 years or something. I don't know if she's not that old, but for a long time, right? And she had, you know, raising her kids and getting her kids off of school until finally she thought, I might as well go ahead and do this. I'm not sure if I can have success or not. She got Phi Theta Kappa scholarship, and she got her Coca-Cola scholarship. She's the GPA honor roll student. She's my star baby. And then Tika, she's another one who's, you know, grandma, you know, who says, oh, I don't have time, but, you know, now saying, I need to do something for my kids. I need something to show my kids that it's never too late to get an education. And they're two of my babies from the very beginning. They'll be graduating in May. And I'll be standing right there next to him as they graduate. So, Dr. Morales.
Yes, well, you know, again, we are very proud of the students and also the program, and certainly it's very rewarding and satisfying the fact that we are able to afford additional opportunities, increase the access to higher education to many more students through our offerings, again, online, dual credit and weekend college, and especially weekend college, as you witnessed this morning. There is a lot that we still need to do in terms of growing programs and expanding. We will entertain any questions from this point forward if you have any. Preguntas.
Preguntas, por favor. Pregúntamelo.
I have a question. We started this program, some sort of accelerated program, like in 2000, and we had the same experience regarding the faculty. We had a lot of faculty who came from the public instruction department, and I told them that it was funny to see them come in the nights and how they were glowing. Because I told them there's nothing better for a teacher to have students that they want to learn. And sometimes
yes.
they don't have that experience
yes.
During the day. But I was going to ask you if you do have like a immersion program for faculty, because it's a total different modality. And what we do is that we ask this faculty, especially when they're in their first try at this modality, to have like a certification, what we call andragogia, which is different from pedagogy,
right.
and that served us a lot, because this is a different experience for them. It's a very different modality, and you need to adapt to the type of experiences that these students have. Especially when they come, and because when we started with the adults program, we got a lot of what you're saying. I mean, people who work, people who are there. But now that we have moved to this modality towards other cultures, not only people living in Puerto Rico, but students who are living in the United States, but Hispanics who are living in the United States, and they do have like a different experience. So we do have to adapt that training depending on the type of the, on this student profile. So do you do that? Do you like kind of certificate this faculty in the modality?
Well, we certify for online.
Hi, Carlos.
Hello. Thank you for the question. Yes, we do not certify faculty for the weekend college as you described in your program. Actually, it's a good point. Now that we are seeing, you know, more interest from faculty, and of course, as we grow the program, we need to create some sort of pathway for faculty to be on that channel, as you described, because, you know, it's a different atmosphere. But no, we are not doing that at this particular moment. But thank you for asking, and also for the hint.
Now, if we can get the, again, people who've been through the online certification, mm-hmm. then that helps out a lot.
Yeah.
Now, something else as you're talking about, you know, transitioning your teachers into this, something that I tried to do, and I'm doing a little bit, it's not 100% successful yet. Remember I said I have English and history together, and these people have been together since day one, the instructors. And so I tell the English instructor, when you do a writing assignment, have them do something of a historical paper. And then the history teacher, when you have them turn in the papers, make sure they do things in the format that the English teacher wants. And so a lot of times these students and these instructors can all work together for the common purpose, and then the students are learning two things at the same time while getting credit, almost like a dual credit type of thing, for one paper that meets English and history requirements. And the instructors are working together, and they share different information of what works and what doesn't work. Our English teacher, we have a new English teacher. This is her second semester with us, or third. And so she has had a lot of help from the other English instructors since day one. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you for the presentation. What about the retention rate and the attrition rate?
You mean retention and attrition rates?
Yes.
Well, you know, in the community college, traditionally it's 50% attrition rate is very high, if you will. However, through this particular program, we are aiming at reducing that, you know, very aggressively, because we are prescribing the whole set of parameters for that student, with, you know, prescribed courses. There is a degree plan. And the tricky element, and there is something that I, you know, at this point it's difficult to explain in terms of why institutions do not enforce, you know, the rules, to some extent, the rules that they have created themselves. But we are an open access institution, and students just go left and right, and that drives the attrition rate, okay? But through this program, we are you know, making an effort to break that cycle. David, do you have any figures from our particular program that you can share with the audience?
Yeah, it's not as clear as it seems. And the problem is that, remember how I told you how I enroll? I have all my students who enroll first, and then I fill up seats with other people. The students who are actually in weekend college, they stay. I mean, once they're there, they're there. It's like, I got in there, I'm doing it, I'm moving on. But then we have students who enroll the butts in the seats who are going, oh my God, this is intense. Mm-hmm. And those people end up leaving, okay? Mm-hmm. And so it's hard to separate which ones are counted as weekend college. However, me, because I'm the director and because I'm in their face every week, mm-hmm. I know who's in my group. And when they're not there, I call them, okay? And it's, so I can tell you about retention, I don't have the numbers, and that's the reason, because it's very hard to track without tagging their ear like we do with cows or something. I'm not quite sure how to do that. I have some numbers, but they're, you can look at them.
Yeah, they haven't graduated yet.
Yes.
Most of them haven't graduated. Well, no, it's like 2 years that you've been doing this.
Well, no, it's been a year and one semester. Yeah.
So the retention, the graduation rate is for the cohort that started 2014. And probably they were only like first time
in college students. I think I had somewhere around 25 students that started all together, 24. I have to go back to that graph there.
Yeah,
I know that like I said, two of them have already graduated for this past December. I'm going to get close to 10 as far as I know.
Since you're just starting with this, I would suggest, I'm giving you another hint, That you do try to keep your statistics from day one, because you're gonna be like feeling, because they get lost, especially in such a big a big environment. They get lost within the other modalities for the institutional number.
Well,
and you really do want to understand how they do the numbers, and try to keep your own statistics for your group, because they're not necessarily gonna be, you're not necessarily gonna be asked for them as well. But you do want to know how much better these students are doing, because I mean, my experience was that, for example, the honor roll. I mean, the number of students in the honor roll, after 2000, 2005, were like, we actually put it higher, the GPA, because adult students are so much more motivated. They also want to be like an example to their kids.
Right.
They don't allow themselves to have anything less than an A.
Right.
And that kind of student, that's what I'm saying, for the faculty, it's like, wow. I mean, I come here and the students are asking me for more, and
yeah.
they don't want to go and they don't want to leave, and it's such a big difference that you do. I would suggest that you do get like a set of statistics that you do want to keep from now on, because you do have your first like graduation class.
Yeah. Part of the problem that we had is that when we first started Weekend College, TCC Connect wasn't a separate campus yet.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So all of our students were classified as some other campus.
Mm-hmm.
And so it made it really hard to try to track statistically.
Yeah.
So it ended up being an individual, like, I know Gina and I know where she is.
Yeah,
so then, and so that made it a little bit different. But as we go to 46 sections this coming up this semester.
But I thought, since you said your cohort, like you select the cohort and follow them like through, so that
right.
you get some sense of how well you're doing, because some things you may need to change. You may find, and that's one of the things that we do, is that we do give them like a student plan, and they do know, I mean, from day one, you're gonna do it and you're gonna finish this at this time if you follow this. And they usually go on like herds. I mean, they go together, and
that
you
is
know
true.
Students.
That is true. I just wanted to say that, you know, certainly appreciate the points there. The district, I don't know if you are familiar with the four disciplines of excellence. Four disciplines of execution. It's 4DX from Colby. And because we are an Achieving the Dream institution, we are a leader college, one of 72 in the nation. This fall, we started something that is called WIGS, W-I-G, little s, Widely Important Goals. And one of those goals for us is to retain 20% of our students from fall to fall.
Okay.
And just so you know, we serve 58,000 students, credit students, another 40,000 through continuing education. So as you may see, we are an extremely large institution.
Yes.
What we were experiencing is that of the about 8,000 students we enroll every fall, we were retaining 50% of those. So, you know, do the math there, you know, how many students we were losing. So now the mandate for us is to increase and retain 20% more of those. So, you know, it's just you know, roughly calculating 50% of 8,000 is 4,000, so 20% more, you know, it's about, you know, 1,500 more students that we want to retain from fall to spring, and again, you know, from fall to fall. So that is in the works, and because we're going to start the semester next week, you know, we are waiting for the set of statistics to see, you know, how that retention has been working. So again, you know, in a future iteration, we will report and share with you guys how that's going.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. I think we're about out of time. Okay. Last question before I'm the only thing that separates you and lunch.
Oh, yeah, that's
in front of the door. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Morales.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Gracias.
I want to that Dr. Morales part of our faculty in San Sebastian. That's what I wanted to do.
That's very true, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. We want
long
to get there. Yeah, several